This video explains how to use CRP5 for units conversion, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the third video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. The relationship between units are usually fixed ratios. For example, 1 imperial gallon is equal to 4.54 liters. Thus it can be solved using circular slide rule. Marked with red arcs is the conversion marking on the computer face of the CRP5. Units conversion that can be done using CRP5 are: distance or length, speed, volume, mass, temperature, and conversion between volume and mass. Conversion between volume and mass will be explained in the next video. Now let's investigate distance or length conversion. First, we will discuss conversion between meters, yards, feet. The conversion factor between these three units are: 1 meter equal to 1.094 yard, equal to 3.28 feet. You are advised to memorize these factors, especially between meter and feet, as it would be extensively used in ATPL examination. However, yards is not within EASA syllabus. Thus it will not be covered within this video. The graphical representation of the relationship between these three units is as shown on the screen. If you have problems in memorizing the conversion factor or forget the conversion factor during the examination, CRP5 can help you to remember it. To do this, align 10 on the inner scale with KM-M-LTR marker on the outer scale. This will represent 1 meter. Next, locate feet marker and align the cursor with it. Read the factor on the inner scale, 3.28 feet. Now, let's take a look at an example. How many feet are there in 4,727 meters? The first step is to find approximation. 1 meter equal to 3.28 feet. For approximation, we take 1 meter equal to 3 feet. For 4,727 meters, we round it up to 4,700 meters. Thus, the approximate value is 3 times 4,700 equal to 14,100 feet. The second step is to locate M marker for meters, and feet marker. Align 47.27 with M marker. Next, align cursor with feet marker. Read off the answer on the inner scale. It is 15.41. The approximate value is in the region 10 of 1000. Thus, 4,727 meters is equal to 15,410 feet. Now let's work out the same question using a calculator. We know that 1 meter is equal to 3.28 feet. 4,727 meter is equal to 4,727 times 3.28. Equal to 15,504 feet. As you can see, calculation using a calculator is faster and more accurate. However, CRP5 can help you to remember the conversion factor. Now let's look at the conversion between nautical mile, statute mile and kilometer. The conversion factors between these units: 1 nautical mile equal to 1.151 statute mile, equal to 1.852 kilometer. Here is the graphical representation of the relationship between these three units. We can use CRP5 to assist us in memorizing the conversion factors. To do this, align the cursor with nautical mile marker, which is marked as naught.m. Next, align 10 inner marker with the cursor. This represents 1 nautical mile. Then read off the conversion factors on the inner scale opposite to statute mile marked as stat.m and kilometer marker marked as km. 1 nautical mile equals 1.152 statute mile. And 1 nautical mile equals 1.852 kilometers. To better understand the operation, let's take a look at an example. Convert 2,650 kilometers to nautical mile and statute mile. To solve this question using CRP5, the first step is to approximate the answer, in order to gauge the magnitude of the final answer. To approximate, we use the roundup conversion factor, which is 1 nautical mile equals 1.2 statute mile equals 2 kilometer. 2,600 kilometers is approximately 1,560 statute miles. And 2,600 kilometers is about 1,300 nautical miles. After we get the approximate value, we use CRP5 to get the answer. First, we locate KM, NOT.M and STAC.M marking. Next, align 26.5 with KM marker. Now we can read off the answer from the inner scale opposite the desired unit marker. Use the cursor to help you read the accurate answer. Opposite of nautical mile marker, the answer is 14.28. And, opposite of statute mile marker, the answer is 16.42. Take a look at the approximate value. Both answers should be in the magnitude of 1000, thus, 2650 km is equal to 1642 statute mile, and 1428 nautical mile. Now let's take a look at speed conversion. Speed units that can be converted using CRP5 are knots, which mean nautical miles per hour, MPH, which means statute miles per hour, and KPH, which mean kilometer per hour. The conversion factor between this unit: 1 knot is equal to 1.15 miles per hour and 1.852 kilometers per hour. As you can see, it is the same as distance conversion. To better understand the operation, let's take a look at an example. Convert 363 knots to mile per hour and kilometer per hour. The first step is to approximate the answer. For approximation, we used roundup conversion factor. 1 knots equals 1.2 miles per hour equals 2 kilometers per hour. 363 knots, we rounded up to 350 knots. Thus 350 knots is equal to 420 miles per hour and 700 kilometers per hour. The second step is to use CRP5 to solve the question. Locate KM, STAT.M and NOT.M marker. Align the cursor to NOT.M marker. Align 36.3 on the inner scale with the cursor to represent 363 knots. Read the answer. For mile per hour, read the answer opposite STAC.M marker on the inner scale. 41.9. For kilometer per hour, read the answer opposite KM-M-LTR marker on the inner scale. 67.4. Our approximate value is in the region of hundreds. Thus, 363 knots equals 419 miles per hour, and 674 kilometers per hour. Now let's take a look at volume conversion. Volume is defined as the amount of space that a substance or object occupies, or that is enclosed within a container. Volume units that can be converted using CRP5 are liter, imperial gallon, US gallon. The conversion factor between these units: 1000 liter equals 220 imperial gallons and 264 US gallons. As you can see, for approximation, we can say that liter is approximately 5 times imperial gallons or US gallons. Imperial gallons and US gallons have roughly similar magnitude. To better understand the operation, let's take a look at an example. Convert 190 imperial gallons to liter and US gallons. The first step is approximation. For approximation, amount in liter is approximately 5 times of imperial gallons. Thus, 190 imperial gallons is approximately 950 liters. Since the magnitude of imperial gallons and US gallons is roughly the same, 190 imperial gallons is approximately 190 US gallons. The second step is using CRP5 to get the answer. First, locate LTR, Imp.Gal, and US.Gal marker. Next, align cursor to imp.gal marker. Then, align 19 on the inner scale to the cursor to represent 190 imperial gallons. Now we can read the answer. For liter, read the answer on the inner scale opposite to KM-M-LTR marker. (80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86). It is approximately 86.4. For US gallons, read the answer on the inner scale opposite to US.gal marker. It is approximately 22.8. Comparing to our approximate value, the answer should be 190 imperial gallons equals 864 liters equals 228 US gallons. Now let's take a look at mass conversion. Mass is defined as the quantity of matter which a body contains. Mass units that can be converted using CRP 5 are kilogram and pounds. The conversion factor between these units: 1 kilogram equals 2.205 pounds. For approximation, we can say that pounds are twice of kilograms. To better understand the operation, let's take a look at an example. Convert 2,700 pounds to kilograms. The first step is to approximate the answer. For approximation, 1 kilogram is approximately 2 pounds. Thus, 2,700 pounds are approximately 1,350 kilograms. The second step is using CRP5 to get the answer. Locate KGS and LBS marker. Align cursor to LBS marker. Align 27 on the inner scale with the cursor to represent 2,700 pounds. Read off the answer on the inner scale opposite to KGS marker. Our approximate value is in the region of 1,000. Thus, 2,700 pounds equals 1,225 kilograms. Now let's take a look at temperature conversion. Temperature is defined as the degree or intensity of heat present in a substance or object, especially as expressed according to a comparative scale and shown by a thermometer or perceived by touch. Temperature units that can be converted using CRP5 are degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit. Temperature conversion is a direct conversion, no approximation is required. The formula to convert between these units are degree Celsius equals degree Fahrenheit minus 32 divides by 1.8. And degree Fahrenheit equals degree Celsius times 1.8 plus 32. To better understand the operation, let's take a look at an example. Convert 30 degrees Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Locate 30 degrees Celsius. Read the answer on opposite scale. 86 degrees Fahrenheit. The second example for temperature conversion, convert 60 degrees Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. As you can see, there are no 60 degrees Celsius marking on degree Celsius scale, since we know that 60 degrees Celsius equal to 2 times 30 degrees Celsius. Thus, 60 degrees Celsius equals 86 degrees Fahrenheit times 2, equals 172 degrees Fahrenheit. Right? Wrong. You could not convert anything out of the scale linearly, you need to use the formula. Degree Fahrenheit equals degree Celsius times 1.8 plus 32. Degree Fahrenheit equals 60 times 1.8 plus 32. Degree Fahrenheit equals 140. Thus, 60 degrees Celsius equals 140 degrees Fahrenheit. In the next video, we will discuss conversion between volume and mass. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you next time.